Hey everyone, the Flipper Zero now integrates with the Raspberry Pi using the video game module. In this video, I'll show you how to customize the firmware in the module. This enables us to use custom bitmaps and to change the color of the HDMI output. I'm using Raspberry Pi logo colors, but you can use any colors you like. I'm going to be using Kali Linux, but I'll also show you how to set up a Kali environment in a virtual machine for Windows. Let's get started. We're using Oracle VirtualBox to host our virtual machine. So you're going to want to head over to virtualbox.org, go to Downloads, and click that Windows Host link to download the file. Once it's done downloading, go ahead and run that installer and accept all the defaults. Next, we'll head over to kali.org and go to Get Kali, and then we'll choose the pre-built VMs. If you have a torrent downloader, you can use that, but otherwise go ahead and just click the download button for VirtualBox. Once it's downloaded, right click, choose extract all, and go ahead and say extract. Once the files are extracted, open up your Oracle VirtualBox manager that you installed earlier. Click on machine and then choose add. Update the path to where you extracted your VM and navigate until you get into that VBox file. Go ahead and say open to that. I don't know if this next step is necessary, but I usually go to settings and then over on system and I change my base memory and give it some more memory. And then on processor, I give it some more CPUs as well. Again, leave a comment if you know if this is necessary. All right, we're ready to run Kali. Go ahead and click start. Our virtual machine will power up and in a minute we'll be running Kali. The default username and password on these VMs is Kali and Kali. I highly advise that you look for some tutorials on how to change that default username and password. That first login can take a minute, and once it's done, we'll go ahead and maximize our VM window. Congratulations, you're running Kali Linux. Next, we'll open the terminal emulator. Type sudo space apt space update and press enter, and then type in your password and press enter. Next, type sudo space apt space upgrade space minus y and press enter. This will take a little while it downloads all the necessary files to do the upgrade. And for me, I got some errors at the end. It doesn't seem to impact anything. Leave a comment if you know what I should do to fix those. Next, type in code and then say yes to the two prompts. Type cmake and say yes to the two prompts. Type sudo space apt space install space protobuf minus compiler and press enter. Then sudo space apt space install space qflipper. We have one more item we need to install. It's a mouthful, so I'll just go ahead and put that in the video description so you can just copy and paste out of there. With all our dependencies installed, we'll go ahead and type mkdir space repo, press enter, and then cd space repo, press enter. Type git space clone space minus minus recursive space https colon whack whack github.com whack flipper devices whack video minus game minus module dot git space vgm. So this is going to clone recursively that repo into a folder called vgm. Once that's done, type cd space vgm. And then if you're an official release firmware on your Flipper, you're going to want to say git space switch space release. And if you're on dev firmware, you're going to want to do git space switch space main. You can run the git space pull command anytime you want to update to the latest firmware in that branch. And then you're going to run cd space build. And this is the folder we use when we're building our firmware. cmake space dot dot and press enter. And then type make and press enter. This is going to build all of our files. Our source files are under VGM app, and our build output is under VGM build app. The UF2 file is our firmware. In Kali Linux, we're going to go ahead and open the QFlipper application that we installed. And then we have to make our flipper available to our Kali box. So go to devices and then go to USB and then choose flipper devices. Our flipper's inside of our virtual machine now. So we'll go ahead and click on files, SD card, right click and say new folder, and we'll make a folder called VGM. You can name this folder anything you want. It's just where we're going to be putting our firmware. And then over in our firmware, we're going to go ahead and drag that in. If you haven't set up your flipper for the video game module, see my other video. We're going to go into tools and then video game module tool. And then we'll choose install firmware from file. We'll go to the VGM folder we created, and then we'll pick that firmware file. And then click on the right arrow button to install it. Again, these firmware files are pretty small, so the install goes fairly quickly. And now we're running custom firmware on our module. Go ahead and click the back button, and hopefully it says module initialized. Next, I'm going to open Visual Studio Code. And then we'll click on File and Open Folder. And then we'll click on Repo and VGM. And then in this case, we want to go into App. And then go ahead and say Open. I'm going to go ahead and say yes, trust the authors, but I don't think that's a necessary step. And now we're going to open the frame.c file. Lines 16 and 17 define the color background and color foreground for our HDMI output. I asked Copilot what the Raspberry Pi hex colors are. I want to use the maroon and the apple green. The video game module uses RGB 565, which is 5 bits for red, 6 bits for green, and 5 bits for blue. So we'll go ahead and ask AI to convert that bright maroon color into RGB 565. So it's coming up with some math formula, but it says C099 is the value. Next, we'll ask about that apple green color, 6C C04A, and get that in RGB 565. And the value is 68C9. We'll edit the color BG value. So that was that orange color, and instead we'll use C099 for the raspberry color. And then for our color FG, we'll change that to 68C9 for that green color. And then in our command prompt, we'll go ahead and type in cmake space dot dot, and then we'll type in make. We'll delete the old file from our flipper. And then we'll drag our new firmware into our flipper. Video game module tool, install firmware from file, and then video game module, and select our firmware file, and then say install. Click OK to module updated, and then click the back button so that the flipper starts mirroring to the HDMI. That is clearly not the purple background with green print that we were expecting. In a new topic window, I'll ask the exact same question again. What is 6C C04A and RGB 565? This time it's telling us a different value. Instead of 68C9 from before, it's saying 6D0A. So I'm going to ask it if it's correct. Usually it'll apologize and give a different answer if you challenge it. I guess not. This time it's confident about its formula. I wish I had the old version to show it to it. So don't always trust your AI. And we'll ask again about the C5-1A-4A in RGB-565. And this time we got C3-OA instead of C099. Next we'll change our background color to the C30A that it told us. And we get a different color, although I'm not sure it's an improvement. 5 bits is a value between 0 and 31, so we'll take 31 times our 0.773 for the red, and that gives us a value around 24. So we'll switch over to Programmer, type in 24, and in binary our 5 bits are 11000. Green is 6 bits, or a value between 0 and 63, so we'll multiply that by our 0.102 for our 10% green. And that gives us a value of around 6. And so for 6 bits, we'll do 000110. Blue is 5 bits, so we'll use 31 and multiply by 0.29 for 29% blue. That's a value around 9. So we'll go ahead and do decimal 9. And in binary, that's going to be 01001. 11000, and then 000110, and then 01001. And that gives us C0C9. So we'll go ahead and update our background color to C0C9. And this time our color looks a lot closer to the intended color. This time I set the color to pure red, and it seems slightly brighter than I expected. This time it's just pure green, and pure blue is also brighter. So I recalculated a darker shade, and I got a hex value of 8086, which looks just about right. So now you know how you can customize your firmware to create different colors on the HDMI outputs. Please like and subscribe. Leave a comment below to let me know what you'd like to do with your video game module. One idea I had was we could update that bitmaps.c to show different images when you plug in the module and disconnect the module. If you come up with a color combination, please share it in the comments. And join my Discord server if you need any help.